I don't want to offend any grandparents out there, but I do need to say this is not your grandma's weather. It's not your grandma's tornadoes, not her hurricanes, not her floods, and definitely not her April snowstorms.
Yes, your grandma and grandpa had a little witty bitty bit colder than we are right now, but we're in the age of mega weather events, according to plain old data. And after enough of this plain old data, one longtime Twin Cities meteorologist gave in to his doubts, acknowledging that we are responsible for worsening our weather. And this week, you will see him on national TV explaining why. For longtime meteorologist and WCCO radio host Paul Douglas,
temperatures are tumbling in the backyard.
The clouds of climate change took years to see.
Were you cynical about climate change?
Sure. Everybody starts or should start from a point of skepticism. Throughout the 80s, most of the 90s, I just didn't think there was enough evidence.
Why? What was missing?
I think, you know, it's funny. We are wired to experience weather. None of us are wired to experience climate. You don't look out your window and see climate. But if you get clubbed over the head repeatedly by increasingly bizarre, jaw-dropping, historic weather events, at some point, it stops being a fluke, an aberration, and it starts to become a trend. And at first I thought I was imagining it. I thought maybe it was my meds. Maybe I was hallucinating. But these patterns kept reappearing, and I reached out to other meteorologists, and they were seeing the same things. Some of them not excited to be talking about it on the air, because you know when you try to connect the dots and when you just whisper climate change, you're going to alienate maybe 30% of the audience who thinks it's a scam, a hoax, a liberal conspiracy. No, no, and no.
Most people sense a change in the weather.
On Wednesday's brand new NOVA documentary on your local PBS station, Douglas will be one of many meteorologists to feature their experiences with climate change.
NOVA really is still the gold standard when it comes to science programming, science documentaries. They were intrigued with trying to present climate change with a different framing, kind of a different perspective. Rather than having climate scientists, they actually were intrigued with the idea of meteorologists seeing some of the apparent symptoms of climate volatility showing up on the weather map.
Douglas, a conservative and a Christian, understands how his change of mind on climate change may appear to some, and to that, he has no apologies.
I think it's a sign of maturity to be able to change your mind on something. I mean, we all live in our bubbles, and we sort of filter out news that maybe threatens our worldview, our political beliefs and aspirations. But this isn't about polar bears. This is about our kids and our grandkids and the legacy we're going to leave to them. Because at some point, your kids are going to ask you, what did you know, when, and what did you do?
Thanks to Paul for talking to us today. The two-hour NOVA special that he'll be on premieres Wednesday night. It's at 7:30 on TPT2. And he said for him, the tipping point was the El Nino weather event of 1998, when all the evidence sort of stacked up for him. And he goes, yeah, there's something going on here. And then from 98 to now, take a look at CO2 levels, take a look at mega rain events, pick your data.
Yeah, totally. Last hurricane season, the shorelines, it's all kind of adding
up. The last weekend.
Yeah, exactly. The last weekend.